Good afternoon, and welcome to North Penn High School Natatorium for this afternoon's women's swimming meet between the North Penn Maidens and the Norristown Eagles. For North Penn Television, my name is Mike Schlotterbeck, along with partner Ralph Asher.
Thanks, Mike. North Penn is coming into this meet 4-0 overall and 2-0 in the Suburban 1 Patriot Division. Norristown is currently 2-5 overall and 0-2 in the Suburban 1 Patriot Division. Our coaches for North Penn are Denise Junis and Don Walsh. Sam Montello and Sharon Dunkey for Norristown. Our officials for this meet are Peter Bunting, Bob Siraki, and Mary Jane Christensen.
Okay, Ralph, our captains for the North Penn Maidens are Alyssa Moser, who's been with the team for 4 years as she's a senior. Alyssa also plays field hockey and lacrosse. Another captain is Jessica Thomas, who also has been on the team 4 years as she's a senior. Jessica also plays water polo. The third captain is Janet Taylor, who's in her second year of swimming, although she's a senior. She's in her second year. Okay, our first event this afternoon is going to be the 200-yard medley relay. For North Penn in lane three, we will have Brittany Jernigan leading off in the backstroke, Ashley Jernigan doing the breaststroke. Butterfly will be Rebecca Grant, and anchoring with the freestyle leg will be Lindsay Jernigan. In lane one for the Maidens, we'll have Janet Taylor backstroke, Katie Paul doing breaststroke. We don't seem to have a butterfly on our roster, and Lee Bococci will be doing the freestyle. In lane five for the Maidens, we'll have Laura DiLuigi doing backstroke, Jess Thomas doing breaststroke, Andrea Umloff doing butterfly, and Ashley McNeil doing freestyle. And now I look back on my roster sheet, and Christina Long is also listed as a freestyler, so either Christina Long or Lee Bococci will be doing the butterfly leg. For Norristown in lane four, we have Jess Lely, Stacey Heckard, Sabrina Bukloski, and Charlene Scheinert. And the girls are off. Coming up first in lane three for North Penn is Brittany Jernigan. Brittany's looking strong in first place into the turn. Let's see how she comes out. Good turn. Good hard push off the wall. You see her dolphin kick off the wall. She looks good. In lane five for the Maidens is Laura DiLuigi pushing for second place. Over in lane one for the Maidens, you will see, who do we have there, Ralph? Janet Taylor doing the backstroke, diving into the water in lane three, and the breaststroke is Ashley Jernigan with the lead. For North Penn, or for Norristown, excuse me, that's Stacey Heckard in the breaststroke. Challenging for second place is Jess Thomas. In fourth place out in lane one, we have Katie Paul for the Maidens. Brittany Jernigan's extended her lead. It looks like the Maidens are going to win this race handily. It looks to me, Ralph, like the race is going to be for second place.
Yes, it does, certainly.
That's Rebecca Grant on the butterfly leg for the Maidens. And in lane five, we will have Andrea Umloff doing the butterfly. Norristown and North Penn are neck and neck for second place. It looks like Andrea Umloff's extending the lead a little bit. Out in front, Rebecca Grant's looking good. Looks like the Maidens are definitely going to take first. I think just a question of who's going to take second place here, Ralph.
It certainly appears that way currently.
Looks like Ashley McNeil will be the anchor leg in the freestyle. For Norristown, Charlene Scheinert. This should be a good one, Ralph. Cruising home to the victory is Ashley McNeil. Excuse me. Cruising home to the victory is Lindsay Jernigan in the freestyle leg in lane three. She'll win the race for the Maidens. And there's Lindsay with the first place finish. Ashley McNeil looks like she's going to get in there. It's close. Will she finish hard? And she gets the second place. The Maidens take a 1-2. That was a pretty good race for second place, Ralph.
Yes, it certainly appeared that way. They were neck and neck for most of the meet.
Yep. Okay, next up will be the 200 freestyle. Yeah, I was kind of surprised, Ralph. Norristown's not really that strong, but they really challenged the North Penn B team. So it looks like we'll have some good races today. Okay, next up we have the 200 freestyle, Ralph, I believe.
Yes.
Okay, let's see. We have Alyssa Moser in lane three for North Penn, Nicole Seward in lane five, and Jen Morelli in lane one. Going back to that previous race, the Maidens won that race in 159.62, and second place The Maidens finished in 209.61, and in third place, Norristown finished in 209.93. Out in lane one, the Maidens finished fourth with a time of 219.76. Okay, back to the next race, the 200 freestyle. For Norristown, we have in lane two, Erica Boyle, in lane four, Charlene Scheinert, and in lane six, Melissa Gambone. With that 1-2 finish, the Maidens go up 12-2 early. Okay, the 200 freestyle is really a tough race. It's not a sprint, but it's not exactly a distance swim either. Girls really have to look to get in a rhythm and finish hard. What else should we look for here, Ralph?
Well, the keys to a win is a good start, pacing yourself well, and good turns through there. There's seven turns in this race.
Yeah, we're going to look for girls to really streamline out of their turns. It's really important to push off the wall and extend your body. In lane three, you'll see Alyssa Moser. She's one of the top swimmers in District 1. Alyssa's also a really good field hockey and lacrosse player. I talked to Coach Denise Junis before the game, and she said Alyssa is not sure about her college choice, but this should be an interesting race. Coach Junis also said Nicole Stewart in lane five has been swimming well, and she's looking for her to challenge Alyssa, so this should be an interesting race. Looks like the mains will be 1-2-3 in this race. I think it's just a matter of who's going to finish where. Hopefully they'll be challenging themselves. All three girls seem to be swimming well, Ralph.
Yes, they do. They're well out in front, and looks like they're going to take it home.
Looks like Alyssa and Nicole will be racing for first, and out here in lane one, Jen's not too far behind either. That's Jen Morelli. And into the turn, we have Alyssa Moser and Nicole Seward pretty much neck and neck. There you see the strong streamlines off the wall. And we can look up the clock and see who's out in the first 100 first. Okay, it looks like it's Alyssa Moser out in 1:01. Nicole Seward's split was a 1:18, so they're really close. This should be a good race. It's good when you have meets like this when the teams aren't as strong to push each other on the same team, and that's what the girls seem to be doing today. And we have three laps left in the race. Okay, Ralph, it looks like the girls are pushing each other. This is good.
Yes, Norristown doesn't even seem to be a problem at this point. They're just challenging each other.
Not at all. And right here, I think, is what you're going to see the rest of the meet. It's evidence of North Penn's depth, and I think the whole afternoon, that's all you're going to see is North Penn first, second, and third most of the meet. All right, it looks like Alyssa Moser's taking charge of this race, but Nicole Seward really has swam well. And Alyssa Moser finishes first with a time of 201.76. That's a good time for Alyssa. I talked to Denise Junis before the meet, the coach, and she was looking for Alyssa to do around a 202, so I think that's a pretty good time for Alyssa. In second place, Nicole Seward went at 204.3, and in third place we had... Who was that? That was Jen Morelli. She finished in 209.29. So a 1-2-3 sweep for the Maidens. Okay, and what's our next event here, Ralph? We have the 200 individual medley. The 200 individual medley is a little different than the medley relay, which we saw two events ago. The medley relay involves four swimmers. This actually involves just one swimmer. Each swimmer does two laps of each stroke, starting off with butterfly, followed by two laps of backstroke, two laps of breaststroke, and two laps of freestyle. And this really is a test of a swimmer's flexibility and versatility. Ralph, any other keys to this race?
Well, they have to have a good start. Good turns are very much a key. Breaststroke can make or break a swimmer.
Okay, Ralph. Okay, once again, the times on that race, Alyssa Moser in lane three finished first in 201.76, Nicole Seward in second, 204.30. In third place, 209.29 was Jen Morelli. In fourth place was a Norristown swimmer in lane four, 230.18. That was Charlene Scheinert. In fifth place in lane two was Erica Boyle in 250.06. And in sixth place for Norristown, Melissa Gambone in 304.66. Now we're getting ready for the 200 individual medley. For North Penn in lane 3, we have Lindsay Jernigan. In lane 1, Kara Ketterer. And in lane 5, Katie Plewinski. And for Norristown, in lane 2, Kristen Getha. In lane 4, Stacey Heckard. And in lane 6, Carolyn Contra. Looks like we're ready to go here, Ralph. Once again, our score going into this race, 25-5 in favor of the maidens. Okay, Lindsay Jordan's taking a quick lead here. Out in lane 5, Katie Plewinski's in second place. And in lane 1, Jen Morelli in third place as we start out with the butterfly. Okay, now you'll see the transition turn as they approach the wall. Swimmers will simply turn on their back and begin the backstroke leg of the race. And out first in lane 5 is Katie Plewinski with a split of 30.57. Okay, Ralph, at the end of this backstroke leg, I think you'll really see the girls start to get tired, and that's what, as you said, the breaststroke leg really can make or break the IM race. It really depends on how much energy they have after the backstroke leg. Once again, we have a case of the North Penn swimmers simply having to challenge themselves, as the Norristown swimmers have seemed to slip back in the pack. And you can't really fault them. You know, they're really trying hard. It's just a matter of North Penn's depth and the tradition. These girls are swimming all year round, whereas a lot of the Norristown girls, this is pretty much the only time of the year that they swim. Lindsay Jernigan's looking strong in the breaststroke. Out in lane 5, Katie Polinski's maintaining second place, but Kara Ketterer's come up a bit. You'll hear the Jernigan name a lot this afternoon, as there's 3 on the team. Along with Lindsay, she has sisters Ashley and Brittany. And Lindsay takes a commanding lead after the breaststroke leg. She's in at 149.52, entering the freestyle leg. And Kara Ketterer has actually caught Katie Plewinski, so they'll battle for second place. And into the turn, it's Lindsay Jernigan cruising the victory. She looks strong. Katie Plewinski seems to extend herself, and I think she's going to finish second. And Lindsay Jernigan finishes off the race in 2:22.53. A good swim for Lindsay Jernigan. Katie Plewinski touches second in 2:30.81, and Kara Ketterer finishes third with a time of 2:32.04. Stacey Heckard will finish fourth as she leads Norristown with a time of 2:49.88. And Kristen Getha and Carolyn Contra will finish their race. And it looks like we have the 50 freestyle to look ahead to, Ralph. What can we look for in that race?
It's a short sprint race. You need to get right up and start swimming. There's hardly any turns in this event, so that's not really very important. It's just they really have to go hard and sprint out the race.
Okay, Ralph. 50 freestyle, one of the most exciting races in a high school swimming meet. Okay, and there we saw Kristen Getha touch fifth in a time of 3:25.40, and Carolyn Contra finished sixth in 3:32.99. Okay, the 50 freestyle. In lane 3 for North Penn, we'll have Rebecca Grant. In lane 5 will be Lindsay Whitmer, and in lane 1 will be Bree Neuschwander. For Norristown, we will have Stacey Heckard in lane 2. Excuse me, that's incorrect. In lane 2 will be Michelle Saylor. In lane 4, we'll have Sabrina Belosky, and in lane 6, Carolyn Contra. I think we're ready for the start. This will be a quick one, folks, so hang on to your seats. Once again, we'll look for Rebecca Grant to take charge early in this race. This race, the start is so crucial in this race.
Okay.
The manager for the Maidens, just so you audience members know, is Chris McKelvey, who doubles up as a lineman on the North Penn football team. Chris is a sophomore here at North Penn. It's his first year as a manager. He's been a member of the North Penn Knights swim team last year. And it looks like we're about ready to begin. With that 1-2-3 sweep in the 200 individual medley, that score makes it 38-8 in favor of the Maidens. Once again, 38-8 entering the 50 freestyle. And they're off clean. And Rebecca Grant has taken a slight lead. It looks like Sabrina Belosky from Norristown will give her a race. Outside in lane five, we have Lindsay Whitmer, who's also up with the pack. It looks like a three-person race. Rebecca Grant and Sabrina Belosky going neck and neck. It looks like Rebecca Grant's nosed ahead a bit. Lindsay Whitmer right there in lane five. On the outside in fourth place is Bree Neuschwander for North Penn. And it'll be Rebecca Grant in first place with a time of 28.00. Stacy Belosky finishes second for Norristown in a time of 28.35. In third place for North Penn with a time of 29.12 is Lindsay Whitmer. In fourth place for the Maidens with a time of 30.08 is Bree Neuschwander. In fifth place for Norristown in lane two with a time of 32.14 is Michelle Saylor. And finishing sixth in lane six is Carolyn Contra for Norristown with a time of 39.28. Our next event will be diving, which will come up as soon as we throw for a break. Remember, next up we'll return to the North Penn Natatorium for the diving portion of this afternoon's Suburban One Conference Patriot Division meet. Back in a moment.
What would you do if you had to choose between the buffalo and the giraffes, between a flower or an elephant? What would you choose? What if you had to decide between a 100-year-old tree and a 1,000,000-year-old beach? Between drinking clean water or breathing clean air? Would you make the right choice? Would there be a right choice? Now there's a way to help. Not just one, but all these things. EarthShare, the world's leading environmental groups working together. It's one choice we can all live with. Ask your employer about workplace giving.
You are 100% unadulterated energy. You have no choice but movement. You aren't acted on. You are action. You have the power to make the world a better place. You already know how to do it. Volunteer now for the American Red Cross. Call your local chapter for details.
Over 2 million acres of our wildlands burn each year, and hundreds of homes are lost as a result.
At least 50 homes were burned to the ground. Dozens more were damaged as fires raced through dense brush and steep canyons.
Flames don't know the difference between forest, rangelands, and homes. Learn how you can fireproof your home. For more information, contact your local fire protection agency, state forestry office, or the USDA Forest Service.
Welcome back to North Penn Natatorium. We're in the diving portion of the meet. Erica Carty starting off for the Maidens. That was dive 201. Erica, a back dive. Looked pretty good, Ralph.
Yes, it did.
And next up, we'll have a North Penn Maiden diver, but I'm not sure who that will be. We don't have the order in front of us. Next up for the Maidens will be Valerie Hendricks, who will also be doing dive number 201, a back dive. Oh, that was a really nice dive. Landed well. Not much splash on that one, Ralph. Next up for Norristown will be Kim Hackard. Viewers will have to bear with us as we don't have the specific dives the Norristown divers will be doing this afternoon, but we'll do our best to let you know what's coming. That dive should score well as well. A 5, a 4, and a 5 for Kim Hackard. Next up will be Nicole Seip for the North Penn Maidens. She will also be doing a back dive. A little bit over on that dive. A 5.5, a 5, and a 4.5 for Nicole. Next up will be Erica Cardi with her second dive and inward. Look like an inward somersault. 6, 5.5, and a 6 for Erica. Next up will be Valerie Hendricks for the Maidens. Our score 49-13 in favor of the North Penn Maidens. A very nice dive by Valerie Hendricks. 2 6.5s and a 6 for Valerie Hendricks. Next up for Norristown, Kim Hackard with her second dive of the afternoon. Hackard looked to go a little bit over on her somersault going past the 1.5 that she was looking for. A 4, a 4, and a 4.5. This will be Nicole Seip for the Maidens. Cole performs an inward rather nicely. 2 5s and a 6.5 for Nicole. Erica Cardi will now perform her third dive. Looks like a reverse by Erica. 4.5, 4.5, 4. The judges give her 2 4.5s and a 4. Next up, Valerie Hendricks from the Maidens with her third dive of the afternoon. A back 1.5. Very nice dive. A 5 2.5s for Valerie Hendricks. Next up, Kim Heckard with her third dive of the afternoon from Norristown. Looks like a reverse somersault by Kim. 3 4s from the judges. Nicole Seit with her third dive of the afternoon from North Penn. Like a forward dive with 1.5 twist from Nicole. Judges seem to like that one. 2 6.5s and a 6. Now we begin our fourth round. Erica Cardi will lead that round off. Another forward dive with 1.5 twist. 2 5s and a 5.5 from the judges. Now we have Valerie Hendricks with her fourth dive. This should be a reverse dive. Seem to over-rotate a little bit. 3 4.5s from the judges. Kim Heckard now. This is Kim's fourth dive of the afternoon. Another forward dive with 1.5 twist. 2 4s and a 4.5 from the judges. Nicole Seit now with her fourth dive. Very nice reverse dive by Nicole Seit. Two 5s and a 5.5 for Nicole. We'll now begin our fifth round of the afternoon. Erica will do a forward dive with 1.5 somersaults. Degree of difficulty on this dive is 1.7. A 6, a 5.5, and a 5 for Erica. Raph, what do we have up next?
We have Valerie Hendricks up next with a forward half, 1.5 somersault.
Okay. Very nice dive by Valerie. Two 5.5s and a 6 for Valerie. Norristown's Kim Hacker will now do an inward somersault. Degree of difficulty on this dive is 1.6. Manning the mics this afternoon is former girls swimming coach Selma Robinson, a legendary figure throughout the halls of North Penn High School. Four, 4.5, and a 5 for Kim Hackard. Next up will be Nicole Sight. Not to be left out of the mix is Mr. Rick Carroll, who was the initial coach of the North Penn Knights swimming team, who retired from his head coaching position in 1988. He headed up the North Penn Aquatics program for over 25 years, winning district and state championships. Mr. Carroll basically established a tradition here at North Penn that's unmatched throughout the state of Pennsylvania. Nicole seemed to over-rotate just a bit on her 1.5. Two 5.5s and a 5 for Nicole. We're now into our final round of diving, and Erica Cardi will start us off. This will be a double somersault, not an easy dive. And Erica lands that nicely. A 4.5, 5, and 5.5 for Erica's final dive. Valerie will now perform her final dive, which also will be a forward double somersault. Excuse me. Good dive by Valerie. She gets scores of 5, 5.5, and 6. Kim Hacker will now perform her last dive for the Eagles. Once again, our score 49-13 in favor of the Maidens. An inward 1.5 attempted by Kim. Have to applaud her for the effort, Ralph.
Yes.
And she achieves 3, 3.5s. Good effort by Kim Hackard, though. Nicole Sight will now perform her final dive, which also will be a forward double somersault. Can't see myself doing these dives, Ralph.
Me neither.
Girls spend hours and hours of times on these dives. And Nicole rotates over a little bit. That'll conclude our final round of diving. We'll get you Nicole's scores in a second. 2 3s and a 2.5. That concludes the diving portion of today's meet. We'll be back in a second with the remainder of the swimming portion on North Penn Television.
They've given our generation a label. X. Generation nothing. They say we have no sense of purpose. They say we have no war to fight and no cause to believe in. Who are they? Join the thousands of us who are making a difference and wear a label that does mean something.
I haven't made up my mind yet. What are you gonna take?
Algebra.
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 Algebra! 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 Algebra!
If no one's explained how algebra, geometry, and calculus can improve your future, demand that you be told. Call NACME. We'll tell you.
Welcome back to North Penn High School Natatorium. We have the results from the diving portion of our meet. In first place for North Penn was Valerie Hendricks with a score of 168.2. In second place for North Penn, Erica Carty with a score of 164.75. And it was a clean sweep for the Maidens as Nicole Seitz finished third with a score of 159.95. For Norristown, Kim Heckard finished with a score of 132.85. We now have the 100 butterfly. In lane three for the Maidens, we have Ashley Jernigan. In lane five, Katie Plawinski. And in lane one, Kelly Rembolt. For Norristown, in lane four, Sabrina Belaski. And lane two, Kim Heckard. Butterfly, the most difficult of the four strokes. And out in front is Ashley Jernigan. And it looks like we'll have a battle for second place. Katie Plawinski looks like she's in second place. Ashley Jernigan split a 30.68. And the second 50 where the arms really tighten up. And it looks like the Maidens will once again sweep this event. Ashley Jernigan in control. And Katie Plawinski and Kelly Rembolt battling for second place. Now you see the arms beginning to tighten up. This is definitely a grueling race. And Ashley Jernigan finishes first with a time of 106.31 for the Maidens. In second place in lane one, we had Kelly Rembolt, and in third place, Katie Plawinski. Kelly Rembolt's time was a 107.91, and Katie Plawinski a 108.95. In fourth place for Norristown with a time of 113.76 was Sabrina Belaski. And finishing in fifth for Norristown, Kim Heckard, with a time of 123.23. Next up will be the 100-yard freestyle. Our score after that event is 75-18 in favor of the Maidens. For the Maidens in the 100-yard freestyle, in lane three is Brittany Jernigan. There's that Jernigan name again. In lane five, Katie O'Brien, and in lane one, Lee Bococci. For Norristown in lane four, we have Charlene Scheinert. In lane two, Tori Hoke, and in lane six, Tina Boyle. Ralph, what can we look for in this event?
The competitors in this event have to have good starts and turns, or they will lose this event. This is a very fast event also, and they're going to have to really keep going in this one.
Thanks, Ralph. This also is a sprinting event. Not as much a sprint as the 50 freestyle, but it's still very important to get out in the start, and the turns are essential. Couple good swims this afternoon for the Maidens. Comes to mind first is Alyssa Moser's 201 in the 200 freestyle. I think Coach Denise Junis has to be happy with that swim. The Maidens really seem to be swimming well with the lack of competition. We'll now wait for the starter. Brittany Jernigan comes up in the lead. Out in lane 5, Katie O'Brien gets off to a quick second place start. Into the turn, they look pretty much even. Looks like this could be another clean sweep for the Maidens, as out in lane 1, Lee Bacocci is challenging. Who do we have in lane 4? Charlene Scheinert. Brittany Jernigan hits the wall in 27.89. Looks like we will have a slight battle for third place here. Lee Bacocci battling with the two Norristown swimmers. Brittany Jernigan looks like she'll cruise home. And it looks like Katie O'Brien will finish second. Charlene Scheinert from Norristown right now in third place as Lee Bacocci tries to catch her. And it looks like Charlene Scheinert will finish third. And Brittany Jernigan wins the race in 57.87. Katie O'Brien finishes in a time of 1:00.78. And finishing third for Norristown, Charlene Scheinert with a time of 1:04.03. Out in lane 1, Lee Bacocci swam a 1:05.73. And for Norristown in fifth place with a time of 1:07.03 was Tori Hoke. And in sixth place out in lane 6, Tina Boyle with a time of 1:15.46. Next up will be our longest race of the day, the 500-yard freestyle. In lane 3 for Norristown, for North Penn, is Laura DeLuigi. In lane 5, Kelly Rembolt. And in lane 1, Janet Taylor. After that 1-2-4 finish by the Maidens, the score 87-22 in favor of the Maidens. We'll go over the swimmers in this event once again once we get started here. As I said, the 500 freestyle, the longest race in a high school swimming meet. Takes a special kind of swimmer to train for this event. As they move on and swim in college, the swimmers swim the 1,000-yard freestyle and the 1,650-yard freestyle. But in high school, the highest they go is the 500-yard freestyle. And I'll tell you what, Ralph, I wouldn't want to swim this event. 20 laps. That's a long way to go, Ralph.
It certainly is.
Okay, looks like we're about ready to get started. And Laura DeLuigi for the Maidens takes an early lead. The swimmers for Norristown in this event. In lane 4, we have Jess Lely. In lane 2, Stacy Heckard. And in lane 6, Lex Petro. In case you forgot, we have DeLuigi in lane 3, Lindsay Whitmer for North Penn in lane 5, and for North Penn in lane 1, Janet Taylor. Looks like DeLuigi's looking to take charge of this race early out, and also out in lane 5, Lindsay Whitmer will try to pace off of her. Well, Ralph, can you tell me a little more about this race?
Yes. This race is a very long race, and it's important for the swimmers to remember to keep to pace themselves and to concentrate on the race. The swimmer can easily lose their place in this race, so the people with the cards at the end of the lanes will pump the cards up and down, meaning the swimmer is going too slow and has to speed up.
Here we see the essence of a team sport as their teammates count their laps and keep them going. Keep their spirits up as you're kind of out there on your own in a 500-yard freestyle. A lot of this is mental, to tell you the truth. Not an easy race, 20 laps all by yourself. But Laura DeLuigi seems to be swimming it just all right today. Lindsay Whitmer still holding second place. And for Norristown lane 4, that's Jess Lely in third place. Janet Taylor trying to give her a run, though. The district qualifying time in this event is 5:42.50. And the North Penn team record's held by Linda Krelovich with a time of 4:57.45. She was the state champ in 1988. Linda's brother Keith went to LaSalle High School. He went on to swim at LaSalle University. He was a butterfly and individual medley swimmer. In case our viewers are wondering why there's no boys events this afternoon, the Norristown High School decided to drop the boys program, which was really a shock to some swimming followers. If one looks up at the North Penn team record board, actually pool record board, you'll see a Norristown swimmer actually holds a pool record from 2 years ago, Andy Smith, with a time of 48.38 in the 100-yard freestyle. And just 2 years later, we've seen the boys program dropped. Hard to believe. For those interested, the pool record in the 500-yard freestyle for the boys is 436.83, held by Tony Bartle, coach of North Penn boys swimming coach. Bill Bartle. Head coach of the Maidens, Denise Junis, is a North Penn High School English teacher. She started coaching at North Penn High School in 1995. Denise is a 1993 graduate of Clarion University, where she was a national qualifier in various distance events, so I think she can relate well to this event. And if we focus back onto the pool, Laura DeLuigi up to her 15th lap as we have five laps to go in this race. Lindsay Whitmer still in third place, second place, and the battle looks to be for third place. That's Janet Taylor outside in lane one. And she's challenged by Jess Lely in lane four. Laura DeLuigi hits the wall in 430.71 as she is about to swim her last 100, in the process of swimming her last 100. Well, Ralph, they pretty much have to be hitting the wall at this point, don't you think?
Yes, it's becoming really apparent that they're becoming real tired since this is such an endurance race.
You heard that starter's gun. What that signifies is the last two laps of the race for the novice watcher. And it looks like Laura DeLuigi is going to wrap up this race. She should go under the District 1 qualifying time of 542.5. And a great swim by Laura DeLuigi, who finishes first with a time of 538.95. So, Ralph, the real question is, could you do 20 laps?
Nah, I can barely make two in this pool.
So, Ralph, you're a sophomore here at North Penn. Does that mean by your senior year your goal will be to make four laps?
Hopefully.
All right. Okay, sorry, lost track here. In lane five, that was Lindsay Whitmer, who finished his second with a time of 607.07. And it looks like, what a race for third place. And that was Jess Lely from Norristown that snuck in for third place, just touching out Janet Taylor. Jess Lely's time was 626.54. Jess Taylor's time was 626.92. Out in lane two for Norristown, that was Stacy Heckard, who finished fifth with a time of 636.56. And finishing up is Lex Petro for the Eagles. And she finishes with a time of 658.42. Excuse me, she's not done. She has two more laps, swimming fans. And Lex swims her final leg. Our next event will be the 200 freestyle relay. We'll try to whip through the lineups for this relay. It'll be tough, but we'll try to get all the names out there. And Lex Petro finishes with a time of 7:42.41. That makes the score 89-26 in favor of the maidens. Okay, the 200 freestyle relay. Are you ready to go, Ralph?
Certainly
appears
that way.
In lane three for the maidens, leading off will be Alyssa Moser. Going second will be Brittany Jernigan. Third will be Lindsay Jernigan, and fourth will be Becky Naldasher. In lane five, leading off will be Ashley Jernigan, second Rebecca Grant, and third will be Kelly Rembolt. Fourth will be Nicole Seward. And in lane one, leading off for the maidens, Christina Long. Going second in lane one will be Bree Neuschwander. Third, Kara Ketterer, and fourth, Andrea Umloff. For Norristown in lane four, we have Michelle Saylor, Lex Petro, Chris Getka, Kim Heckard. In lane six, Megan Walsh, Mel Jamboni, Kathleen Fowler, and Carolyn Contra. In lane two, Tina Boyle, Tori Hoke, Jamie Getka, and Crystal Bird. We await the start. Once again, your leadoff swimmers for the maidens. In lane five, Ashley Jernigan. In lane one, Christina Long, and in lane three, Alyssa Moser. This is the fastest high school relay you'll see in a meet, the 200 freestyle relay. It's a sprint relay, four legs of a 50 freestyle. Once again, as Ralph said earlier, in the 50 freestyle, the keys to this race, really the starts and the turns along with the finishes. Swimmers spend a lot of practice time getting down the timing on the relay starts in and out of the finish. Once you get to the championship and the district and the state level, every little second counts, and that can be made on the finish, on the start, on the turn, or on the relay transitions. And we have Alyssa Moser out to a quick lead. Looks like we'll have at least a 1-2 from the maidens. I think it's just a question if we'll have another 1-2-3 sweep. Alyssa Moser swimming well in lane three. Out in lane five, that's Ashley Jernigan giving her a push. And in lane one in third place, we have Christina Long. Brittany Jernigan hits the water first in lane three. Out in lane five, that's Rebecca Grant. And in lane one, Bree Neuschwander. Alyssa Moser split a 26.62. Lindsay Jernigan will hit the water next for in lane three for North Penn. Out in lane five, we'll have Kelly Rembolt. And in lane one, we'll have Kara Ketterer. Anchoring the maidens team in lane three will be Becky Naldasher. The anchor leg in lane five will be swum by Nicole Seward. And the anchor leg out in lane one will be swum by Andrea Umloff. Looks like a clean sweep is in order for the maidens as long as they hold their start. Becky Naldasher finishing off the race strong for the maidens. The district qualifying time in this event, by the way, is a 1:50 flat. And the maidens go well under that with a time of 1:44.92. The maidens B team out in lane five with a time of 1:43.07 finishes second. And in lane one, the maidens finish third with a time of 2:00.60. Norristown's team in lane four will take fourth, and their team in lane two will take fifth. Our next event will be the 100-yard backstroke. For the maidens, in lane one will be Kim Klein, in lane three, Jen Morelli, and in lane five, Jess Thomas. For Norristown in lane 4, we'll have Jess Lely. In lane 2, Megan Walsh. And in lane 6, Melissa Fowler. After the 200-yard free relay, our unofficial score here at North Penn Television, the Maidens 103, the Norristown Eagles 26. Once again, our score is unofficial. The official score is kept at the scorer's table. We keep a running score here at North Penn Television. For viewers that are interested, individual races, first place scores 6 points, second place 4 points, third place 3 points, fourth place 2 points, and fifth place 1 point. In relay events, first place garners 8 points, second place 4 points, and third place 2 points. Once again, we're awaiting the 100-yard backstroke. Anything we should look for in this race, Ralph?
You on the start, you want to look for a nice streamlined kick under the water. Some might do a dolphin kick, like a butterfly kick on your back, off each wall in a turn.
As Ralph said, the start even more important in this race since the swimmers start from the water. Two starts are available to the swimmers. You could see some swimmers actually stand up holding the block, which is legal in the Pennsylvania Interscholastic Athletic Association. Swimmers may choose to be in the water itself. Looks like Jess Lely from Norristown will be the only one doing a stand-up start. And Jen Morelli takes a slight lead. Jess Lely right there, though. A strong turn from Jen Morelli. Maiden swimmers Jess Thomas and Kim Kleiner are going to have to work and earn these second and third places here. It doesn't look like a clean sweep this time. Jen Morelli maintains her lead. Out in lane 1, Kim Kleiner giving it a go. Slightly catching up to Lely. Klein and Thomas right there for third. And Jen Morelli will win this race handily. Just a matter of what her time is. And she finishes in 107.21. Lely from Norristown finishes in 110.21. And Jess Thomas from North Penn finishes third with a time of 112.49. Kim Kleiner from North Penn finishes fourth with a time of 113.04. Megan Walsh in lane 2 for Norristown finishes fifth. We await a time on that. Looks like the timing pad might be malfunctioning. There it is, 138.98. And Melissa Fowler finishes in 151.58. Our next race will be the 100-yard breaststroke. And our unofficial score, 122.33 in favor of the Maidens. Our last individual event, we'll see Ashley McNeil in lane 3 for the Maidens, Andrea Umloff in lane 5, and Christina Long in lane 1. For the Eagles in lane 4, Michelle Saylor, in lane 2, Crystal Bird, and in lane 6, Tori Hoke. The district qualifying time in this event, 114.50. An interesting feature of the breaststroke that viewers will see is you're allowed one pull and one kick under the water, which is known as a pullout. You won't see this in any other stroke, which makes the breaststroke unique. We await the start. Once again for North Penn, Ashley McNeil, Andrea Umloff, and Christina Long. Thank you. And as you see, Ashley McNeil takes advantage of her pullout. That's one pull and one kick underwater and comes up with a big lead. McNeil looks very smooth. Christina Long in lane one with a slight advantage in second place. And Andrea Umloff right up there in lane five in third. If you focus on the swimmers underwater, you'll see the one pull and one kick allowed. Christina Long out in lane one in first place, her split of 37-68. It's Christina Long with a slight advantage over Ashley McNeil. All three North Penn swimmers in the contention for first place. Christina Long maintains her lead out in lane one. Strong pull out from Long. Andrea Umloff pulls up in the second place. Looks like Christina Long may hold on. Umloff closing strong. It looks like outside smoke, Christina Long in lane one wins the race with a time of 1:19.93. Umloff finishes second with a time of 1:21.78, and Ashley McNeil finishes third with a time of 1:24.25. Once again, a clean sweep by the maidens. For Norristown, lane four, Michelle Saylor finishes fourth with a time of 1:34.63. In lane six, Tori Hoke with a time of 1:39.05 finishes fourth. And in lane two, Crystal Bird finishes sixth with a time of 1:45.52. Ralph, it looks like we've arrived at the final event of the evening. What do we have next? The 400-yard freestyle relay. Anything we can look for in this event, Ralph?
You should look for quick starts and good exchanges between swimmers.
Thanks, Ralph. Our score unofficially after the breaststroke, North Penn 1:35, Norristown 36. Unfortunately, we don't have the order of this event. We do have the swimmers in each lane, though. For North Penn in lane three, we have Katie Paul, Nicole Seward, Ashley Jernigan, and Jen Morelli. In lane five, Rebecca Grant, Katie O'Brien, Katie Pawlinski, Kelly Rembolt. In lane one, Kara Ketterer, Bree Neuschwander, Lee Bikochi, and Jess Thomas. For Norristown in lane four, we have Charlene Scheinert, Stacey Heckard, Jess Lely, Sabrina Bolaski. In lane two, Kristen Getko, Megan Walsh, Jamie Gekka, and Crystal Bird. And in lane six, Lex Petro, Kathleen Fowler, Carolyn Contra, and Melissa Gambone. Once again, we don't have the order in front of us, but we'll do our best. 400 freestyle relay, a little bit different than the 200 freestyle relay in that the swimmers swim four laps each. Still a sprint, though. Looks like the maidens have taken a commanding 1-2 lead. The team in lane one battling with the team in lane four from Norristown for third place. Well, Ralph, another dominating performance by the maidens.
Yeah, certainly. They've been dominating all afternoon, and it doesn't appear that they're going to let go now.
No, it doesn't. This win will push the maidens' record to 5-0. Their conference record, Suburban One Patriot Division record will move to 3-0. Coming into this meet, Norristown was 2-5. They'll drop to 2-6. In the conference, Norristown was 0-2. They'll drop to 0-3. A strong overall performance from the maidens. Sometimes it is a bit difficult to get up for this meet, but it appears the maidens came ready to swim this afternoon. And North Penn's A relay in lane three with a slight advantage. Split on that first leg, 101-18. Norristown's A relay staying up with the maidens in third place. Their leadoff leg was 103.63. Wouldn't want to leave out the maidens' assistant coach, Don Walsh. He's in his first year as a North Penn girls' assistant coach. Don's a North Penn High School graduate and swam from 1990 to 94 at North Penn High School. At one time, Don was the record holder in the 100-yard backstroke at North Penn. Don currently is a student at LaSalle University, and his major is special education. Don also helps out as a coach for the North Penn Aquatic Program and the Hatfield Summer Program. Both Coach Junis and Walsh must be happy with this performance. And we're into our third leg. Maiden's first and second teams taking a commanding lead. Battle once again for third place if we've seen often this afternoon. Ralph, it's been a pleasure this afternoon. Maybe one of these times we'll have a little bit more of an exciting meet, but I have to say the Maiden swam well.
Yes, they certainly did. They were very consistent. They placed first and second in most meets, and first, second, and third in most meets also.
I know we have unofficial scoring in front of us, Ralph, but I believe the Maidens won every event and might have even finished second in every event. Don't quote me on that, but I think that might be right. Maids will next be in action at the Wilson Relays on Saturday. They return to Patriot Division action on January 14th against Penridge High School. That meet, by the way, is a double dual meet, which means the boys will also swim in that meet, and that is at North Penn High School, and it will start at 3:45, so don't be afraid to come on out and cheer the Maidens and the Knights on. Last year, the Maidens finished second at the District 1 Championships, and I know they're looking to improve on that finish and become District 1 champions. Maidens finished 10th at the PIAA Championships last year. And there's the final first place of the afternoon for the Maidens. They finished with a time of four minutes flat, .61. Maidens finished second out in lane five with a time of 4:08.78. Norristown finishes third with a time of 4:23.65. And the Maidens finished fourth with a time of 4:26.19. The two Norristown relays will finish up here this afternoon. As we close out here this afternoon, I'd like to give a hearty thank you to Sarah Snyder and Mattel Ajmera, our two camera people, and also to Bob Gilmer and Mary Fakish in the production truck. And Norristown finishes. No, they don't finish up. They're still going in lane six. Is this an Energizer commercial? Still going. Did you get that, Ralph? Still going. There's a finish from Norristown in lane two. Fifth place, 5:25.95. The Maidens should be challenged in the Wilson Relays on Saturday. And that finishes up the race and our event and the meet. Norristown finished that with a time of 5:59.01. Well, as you see, the North Penn Maidens have quite a squad, Ralph. It's been a great afternoon, swam really well. For Ralph Asher, my name is Mike Schlotterbeck for North Penn Television. Our final score here at North Penn Natatorium, the North Penn Maidens, 147, Norristown 38. Once again, for Ralph Asher, I'm Mike Schlotterbeck for North Penn Television. Thank you and good night.
are you?
Seymour Smoke. Smoke detector. The more smoke I see, the more noise I make. And I see more smoke coming from that toaster.
Thanks for warning us, Seymour.
That's my job. I hate smoke. It's disgusting. It gives me a headache. So whenever I see it or smell it, I make this noise to warn you. Because where there's smoke, there may be fire.
Good tip, Seymour.
How many smoke detectors do you have in your home? Count them. Is there one outside your bedroom? There should be. Tell your parents.
Be cool about fire safety.
Be cool. Over here.
I've had the same friend since I was a little kid. But this year, some of them started playing with these other kids. I guess there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, it's cool making new friends and all, but they weren't like us. They were, you know, different. And I heard my big brother saying some pretty bad stuff about people like them. But they seemed pretty cool, and we had a pretty good time. So, well, maybe my brother doesn't know everything.
Hey, Carlos, come on, we need you.
Don't be afraid.
Be your friend.
Ah, that's my nephew Scruff reading that comic book.
Improving my mind.
Give me your magic zapper and I'll improve your mind.
Hey, that's me.
Look inside. It's about the adventures you have coming home from school.
Uh-oh.
It gives tips on what to do about bullies, finding drugs, or trouble on the bus. And it shows what happens to Scruff.
What happens? What happens?
You'll see. For your free copy, write McGruff, Chicago, Illinois, 60652, and help me take a bite out of crime.
What happens? What happens?
Billy wants to work on airplanes when he grows up. Maybe one that you fly in. Now, would you like this free booklet of simple ways you can help improve his education? Call 1-800-96-PROMISE. Sally wants to be a surgeon someday. Maybe she'll operate on you. Now, would you like a free booklet of simple ways you can help improve her education? Call 1-800-96-PROMISE.
Only you
can prevent forest fire.
And it's Jim.
We know we can count on you to do what Smokey says.
Drown your campfires with water. Make sure it's totally wet. Then stir and drown again.
We know we can count on you to do what Smokey says.
Only you can prevent forest fires.
Chemistry class led me to a life of crime. I catch murderers, rapists, and thieves with a microscope. Help your daughter become a scientist. Instead of a tea set, get her a chemistry set. Look at the boring job I got from being a science nerd. Expect the best from a girl. That's what you'll get.
They've given our generation a label, X, Generation Nothing. They say we have no sense of purpose. They say we have no cause to believe in. Who are they? Join the thousands of us who are making a difference and wear a label that does mean something.